it is Monday, August 2nd at 11:17. It's Liza's birthday. I'm going to try and stop by her classroom today so that you guys can see her for her birthday and so that I can show you her classroom, because I was supposed to help her redo her classroom, like completely redo it, and then I hurt myself and became useless to any and everybody that needed my help. But she got it done with her husband and her kids. It looks great. So I'm going to try and stop by her classroom after my meeting today. I'm on my way to school. I have a meeting at noon with the principal about the house system. This is not my first contract day. That is not until Wednesday, but he asked that I come in to meet with him today, and I said yes. So I'm headed to the school to do that and drop off. I have like a box of books that I've just been sitting in my house, honestly, for about a year or so, because I bought them last summer thinking that the school year was going to start back somewhat normally, and then it didn't, so they just have been sitting in my house. So I'm going to take them to my classroom. So this morning I woke up at 9. I did the same 10 minute stretch through the Peloton. I think those 10 minute stretches are, I've only done it 2 days, but I do think that that's helped quite a bit. And my goal is I'm going to try to take Riley on a shortened walk today. So normally when I take Riley on a walk, it's about a 30 minute walk. So I'm going to see if I can cut it in half and take him on a 15 minute walk, because I just feel so bad for Riley. He looks so sad and so expectant every day around the time that I would normally take him out. And I Googled like just what I should be doing to kind of get over the sciatic pain. And I've been reading that you need to do like some light movement, like light walking, stretching, yoga. I've had several people ask about a chiropractor. Right, that's not what I want to do right now. I don't feel like anything is out of place. Like, I don't feel like a back is a disc or anything is out of place, because like I said, my back is not really giving me the issue. It's just this one spot in my leg, like on the side of my leg. That's number one. Although I'm not naive enough to not think that my back might still be an issue as to why I'm having that pain on my side, if that makes sense. Number two, I'm just very uncomfortable at the idea of a chiropractor right now. Like, chiropractors have always made me nervous when I see people go to the chiropractor, and I feel like in order for your appointment at the chiropractor to be productive, you have to relax enough to allow them to do what they need to do. And I know that I won't relax enough just yet because I'm nervous. So what I would prefer to do right now, it's just to continue to stretch, get massages, and then monitor it. And if it doesn't get any better, which I don't think that's going to be the case, because I do feel progressively, incrementally better each day. But if it turns out that things are not getting better, then I'm going to go to the doctor and see what they want me to do. And speaking of doctor, I need to switch my doctor, because the doctor I've been going to has moved to a different location, which is just not convenient for me. So I need to see about switching that over. So that's the update on the leg. Yesterday I got a little discouraged, because just when I felt like I was making progress, I had to go back to Target to exchange something. And just the brief little bit of time I was walking around in there, by the time I got in the self-checkout line, my leg was on fire. So that was discouraging. So I don't know. So I'm just gonna, you know, take it one day at a time. I'm wearing my back brace today, the back brace that I got from my myomectomy, just to kind of help with my posture. And yeah, that's where we're at. So I did that. I put the rest of my laundry away, and I had to, speaking of medical, had to make another appointment to get another mammogram. So I got my results in the mail, and it said that I had dense breast tissue, which made it hard to read, so I needed to come in and have another one done. Of course, that gives me anxiety. They said it's not abnormal to have dense breast tissue, but nonetheless, I need to go back in there and be retested. So I left a message to make a new appointment. Prayers that everything is fine and that They just weren't able to read the image that was taken. So that is what's going on. So I'm having this meeting. I need to exchange or return two bras from Harper Wild. The cup size, I think, is too small. So I'm going to exchange them for a larger size. And then I am just going to go home and continue to do a little bit of work. So, and I might cook later on, even though I have leftovers from yesterday. I have a manicure tomorrow, and tomorrow is my actual last day of summer break. And I probably won't want to cook when I get home from my manicure. So I'm going to get this stuff out of my car, go in my classroom for a bit, and then go to this meeting. And that's it right now. So see you soon.
What if I wake up happy? And what if I wake up sad? Sorry if I said something that made you mad. Wishing that I could call you. Sorry, my service bad. My bad. When I wake up, you're not next to me. Guess I'm missing all your energy. That's all I want.
That's all I want.
Promise I am not your enemy. I just need another memory. That's all I want. 'Cause all I want is you. Is you.
Get some markers,
okay, and you just trace. Crayola?
Yeah, I got like, it was like a big pack of Crayola markers, like the thinner ones.
How long did it take you?
It doesn't take very long.
On regular chart paper like this?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah. I mean, they're going to be much cuter than that.
I need you to show me.
It's 2:30. We're in Liza's room.
You know why I'm laughing?
Why?
Because you said it's time for new magazine holders, and I just checked. I'm like, is it there?
I'm gonna show them. These are Liza's magazine holders. Look. Oh boy.
You know what the problem is? Latawnya's a little judgy, and so she just said to me, it's time for new magazine holders.
I said in a very nice tone.
I know, but so I sat here and I'm like, is it though? And I looked and I was like,
it sure is. It sure is.
You guys want to send some magazine holders to Smarty Style? So sad.
It's her birthday. She's 22.
Uh huh. Plus a few.
But I came to show you her room. I was supposed to help her. She did this all by herself with her husband.
She got injured.
And her kids, because I couldn't. But this is called industrial chic.
Yeah.
Industrial chic. Doesn't it look nice? I mean, it's in transition, but you get the gist. Is this all the extra paper you have to send back?
Yeah, because I bought 30 rolls and I really didn't need 30 rolls. That right there is $470 worth of
okay, so that's about $500 worth of paper right there, because we have put together a mini of classrooms, and there is nothing like being like in the groove of putting up paper and then you run out. So before I injured myself, I told her just get all the paper, just buy all the paper and just return what you don't need. So
you know what I heard people are doing is on Amazon or other places, they're now selling them for double the price.
I bet.
I said I could have been in front of the district office just
selling it. Because that's what they were doing with Starbucks cups. Like they buy them and then they like quadruple the price.
Should you and I do that as a side hustle?
We could.
That might be good.
So this is it. It looks really good. I just came by to see her in person and wish her a happy birthday.
Oh, no.
She's in her mind, she's officially back. Like we don't have to be back until Wednesday, but she's here.
I was wondering why you weren't back yet. I even called you at
She called me at 7:30 in the morning, and she knows good and well.
Did it rain?
As my aunties would say, she knew good and well I wasn't going to be awake. So the phone rings, and I woke up and said, who in the world is calling me at this time?
What if it was an emergency?
And then I picked up the phone, and not only was it a call, it was a FaceTime call. And then it stopped ringing,
And then it rang again. It was almost as if, I'm like, I was like, and she called me twice.
Well, why couldn't you just answer? Maybe it was an emergency.
I had my bonnet on. I was half asleep.
I think because you were showing all of your salads for work. I thought you were at work.
Oh, no.
I noticed
no.
You love a Greek salad.
I love, well, that's because I'm not exercising. That's the least caloric.
More than the...
I really like that kale salad, but I feel like that's doing, that dressing is a little... It's a little much. So... But we're gonna go to happy hour on Thursday. But this is a room I feel so bad. This is the first year where I just didn't help. And she knows, I really couldn't. I really couldn't.
You're
do
gonna
it.
Go with your cane?
I couldn't do it. I couldn't do it. So, how are you feeling about the start of the school year? Are you happy?
I'm really excited. Oh my God,
don't
sorry,
fall.
My arm. I'm really excited that the kids are gonna be here all day.
Yeah.
I just am nervous because. The talk of the town is we might be shutting down again, you know, right?
Who says that? Oh, flu season.
And I tucked away my webcam so well that I couldn't even find it to join a Zoom today, so I don't even know.
I took that webcam down, I put that microphone, I stuffed it all.
You were like, last Zoom on
Yeah, I even in my Google Drive, all the online learning, I turned that folder gray. I don't want to see it.
My virtual learning page is all archived, so I
don't want to see another Bitmoji
People love
it. I'm like, remember, I was looking at some of that. I was like, remember when Bitmoji like just popped up and everybody was
a big deal.
So yeah, I hope the school doesn't shut down.
No, we can't do that again.
But this is her room. It's very nice. It's industrial chic.
Industrial chic.
So I'm gonna go make some returns. What are you about to do?
I'm about to figure out how to do these
anchor charts
that you're gonna teach me.
Yeah, I put her on to Amy Grossbeck.
Yeah.
She's gonna look at those. So,
does Amy Grossbeck watch your channel?
I doubt it.
If you're watching,
if you do, hey,
we're fans.
All right, talk to you guys later. Bye. I'm home now. Obviously, it is a little bit after 5:30. It's about 4:45. And I've been home for a couple of hours. I left Liza's, dropped off my bras that I need to exchange with Harper Wild. That was a nice and easy process. And then I went to Office Max and I thought I had everything all figured out. I had emailed myself the documents I wanted to print. And then for whatever reason, it wasn't working. So I had to have them do it for me. So I'm gonna show, I need to put you guys down somewhere. All right, there really is nowhere for you guys to be put and I don't feel like getting up. So what I've been wanting to do, I think I came up with this idea last summer and then it just didn't materialize in a virtual setting. So Unit 1 of Study Sync is mystery. And the kids have a writing project where they write a story. And when I taught third, when I taught fifth, and when I taught eighth, having kids generate an idea for their own story just tends to be a challenge for most. Like they just get lost in the concept of coming up with their own idea. So I thought of this to kind of help with that. So these are images that I had printed from the book The Mysteries of Harris Burdick by Chris Van Allsburg. And if you're familiar with the book, I have the actual book in my classroom, and when I get closer to this assignment I'll show it to you. It's just a book of black and white images that are mysterious, and so, and they have a title and like a line. So my thought is I'm going to print these out, which is what I had done today, and then laminate them. And then as I'm introducing the extended writing project, which I intend to do earlier in the trimester, and it's something they'll be working on over the course of the trimester, is have the kids select an envelope that has one of the images in it. So they don't know what the image is, they're just selecting an image and they randomly get it. And at some point their story has to incorporate the image, hold on, has to incorporate the image that they have. The title is what the title of the image is going to be. So that's gonna be the title of their story. And somewhere in their story, they have to have the line that goes with the picture. So here's one picture. I don't know if you can see it very well. It's just of a girl sleeping and there's a book in front of her and there's like ivy coming out of the book. And this one is titled Mr. Linden's Library. And the line says, he had warned her about the book. Now it was too late. So whoever gets that knows the title of their story is going to be Mr. Linden's Library. This image has to somehow be incorporated in their story as well as that line. This is just an idea I had. I have no idea if it's gonna work, but basically I went to Office Max to have these printed out because it just is much more efficient than me printing it out on my little printer here. And then I'm going to laminate them right now using my little Scotch laminator, all while watching another episode of Black-ish. So that is what's up. Aside from that, when I came home, I ate some lunch, went on Instagram for a minute, and then I think I fell asleep and took a nap. It wasn't very long because I set the timer for like 45 minutes, and I feel like within 20 minutes I woke up, but I have just been tired. It's like my body knows, like we're going back to work. So that's what I'm doing now. And I'm gonna do that. And then at about 7 or so, I'm gonna try and take my little brother out on a WALK. And I'll let you know how that goes. And then I'll probably close the vlog after that. So time to laminate.
What if I wake up happy? And what if I wake up sad? Sorry if I said something that made you mad.
Just got home. I'm taking Riley on a baby walk. He's still, where is he? There he is. He still has a little bit of energy, and I'm sure he's wondering why that walk ended so quickly. We were outside for like 15 minutes or so. The walk itself wasn't 15 minutes, it just took 15 minutes. There were two instances where I had to stop and sit on the curb just to rest for a minute because the pain that occurs is like in my shin bone or something, like towards the bottom of my leg. And so that wasn't happening to me earlier today, and I think it's just my legs are tired. So I walked a quarter of a mile, which is about 3/4 of a mile less than what I normally do, but it's progress nonetheless. We will eventually get back to where we can walk a full 30 minutes, but he at least got to go outside a little bit. Right, Riley Roo? So I am just here to end the vlog for the day. I'm gonna go downstairs, eat some leftovers, just try and relax and soak in the last few hours of freedom that I have. So if you enjoyed today's vlog, please give it a thumbs up. If you're not subscribed, make sure you subscribe. And if you'd like to wish Liza a happy birthday, please do so in the comments. But as always, I hope that you guys are well. And if you're not well, please be well. And I will see you guys tomorrow for my last day of summer break. Bye.